Regeneron COVID-19 antibody treatment could reduce viral levels, improve symptoms. Biotechnology company Regeneron Pharmaceuticals unveiled the interim data of its COVID-19 clinical trials. The treatment called REGEN-COV2 is an antibody cocktail designed to lower viral levels and enhance the recovery of patients. To be specific, it is meant for patients who are not hospitalized due to COVID-19. According to CNBC, the data showed the first 275 trial patients. The experimental treatment was tested in two patient population groups. The first population group had an effective COVID-19 immune response, or seropositive, while the second group had no adequate COVID-19 immune response, or seronegative. Investigators compared the effects of the treatment in both population groups. Placebo shots were also given to controls. Results showed that the average recovery time of seropositive controls was 7 days. That was faster than the 13 days average recovery time of seronegative patients. But seronegative patients who were given REGEN-COV2 had reduced viral levels through day 7. The experimental treatment had a better effect in those who had higher viral levels. For seronegative controls, the average recovery time was 13 days. Seronegative patients who receive a low dose of REGEN-COV2 had an average recovery time of 6 days, while 8 days for those who receive a higher dose. The company reported serious adverse events during the trial. 2 patients in the placebo group and 1 patient in the low-dose group had serious side effects. No one died during the trial period. Dr. George D. Yancopoulos, president of Regeneron, said, "We are highly encouraged by the robust and consistent nature of these initial data, as well as the emerging well-tolerated safety profile." The trial findings suggested that the REGEN-COV2 intravenous treatment was well-tolerated by patients. However, the data could only support the drug's use among non-hospitalized mild and moderate COVID-19. Investigators are still continuing the clinical trials. The drug is being studied as a potential addition to standard care for COVID-19. It is also being studied for hospitalized COVID-19 patients. Out of 275 participants, 56% were Hispanic and 13% were African American. About 64% of individuals had one or more risk factors for severe COVID-19. More than 40% of the participants were found with obesity. The Phase 2 of 3 trial will include hospitalized patients and at least 1,300 participants. Also, investigators plan to assess the drug's effects on the upper respiratory tract viral shedding.